Good evening. I'd like to call the council meeting of Monday, December 19, 2022 to order. If I can have our city clerk, please call the roll.
Mayor Flores.
Present.
Deputy Mayor Tharp.
Present.
And Councilmember Noble is absent. Councilmember Dugo.
Here.
And Councilmember Diaz.
Here.
Councilmember Bousquet.
Here.
Mayor, we have a quorum.
All rise for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
All right. Moving on to agenda approval, do I have a motion to approve the agenda?
Motion. Second.
All right, I have a motion made by Councilmember Dugo, second by Councilmember Diaz. All in favor?
Aye.
All right, that motion carries 4-0. All right, comments from the public for agenda items only. Anyone wishing to speak on any agenda item, please come forward, state your name and address for the record. All right, seeing no one, moving on to special business. Tonight, we have a presentation for the 2022 City Photo Contest winner. I'm going to invite our local State Farm agent, Blanca McCray, to come up to the podium, and also our Director of Community and Recreation Services, Michelle Thompson.
Good evening, Mayor, members of the council, members of the audience, and our winners. Thank you for being here. For the record, Michelle Thompson, Director of Community and Recreation Services, and I'm here with our long-term photo contest sponsor, Blanca McCray. She's the owner of State Farm in Lake Worth Road. And since 2018, we've been doing this contest, and Blanca has been generous enough to really, every year, step forward and do the awards for our first, second, and third place winners. And every year, our contest is growing a little bit. This year, we had 74 submittals. Out of the 74 submittals, 27 of them were viable for enlargement and reproduction, basically. So I'd also want to thank this year's committee members. We have 9 committee members from different departments. Those committee members are kind of elected for service through the department directors. And we had Kasturi Rodriguez from the city clerk's office, Sheriff Stewart from Human Resources, Corrine Dawes from Finance, Nicole King from Community and Recreation Services, Crystal Biovian from Fire Rescue, Monica Powery from Purchasing, Candy Tejeda from Development and Neighborhood Services, Eileen Hernandez from Public Works, Ben Dexter from Youth Programs, and of course, Blanca was our tiebreaker if we had a tiebreaker, so as judge and sponsor. We'd also like to thank one of my employees, Loris Baez, who goes through all of the submittals to make sure that they reach the pixels and they reach the criteria for judging. It takes a tremendous amount of time, so we appreciate her expertise in that. And I'm going to turn it over to Blanca so she can award and announce their winners.
Thank you. Michelle, thank you so much for everything that you do and for always finding a way to involve the small business community. I really appreciate you. Okay, so we'll start first with our third place winner. I know that she's not here, but I'd like to announce her for the record. Our third place winner was Ashley Baroncelli with her water lily. Yes. Yay! All right, and then we'll have a drum roll. So our second place winner is Amy DiMartino with her mom and baby duck picture.
Aww.
Congratulations, beautiful.
She's been in my wake for a year, and I've been watching them grow, so now they're immortalized. And if you haven't seen the previous years around town, it's beautiful to see them on the junction boxes. Yes. Throughout the community. Okay, and our first place winner is Douglas Ruby with his beautiful dragonfly.
Beautiful.
Thank you so much. That was awesome. All right, moving on to our consent agenda. Do I have a motion to approve the consent agenda?
So moved.
Second.
All right, I have a motion by Councilmember Diaz, second by Deputy Mayor Tharp. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
That motion carries 4-0. All right, moving on to our regular agenda. We have a public hearing for Ordinance 2022-35. It's first reading. If I can have our city clerk, please call the read the ordinance by title.
Ordinance 2022-35, first reading, amending Chapter 16, Article 3, District Regulations, Division 11, Commercial Intensive Section 16-499-30 to allow for outside car detailing as standalone car washes within the Commercial Intensive Zoning District, providing for repeal of conflicting ordinances, severability, inclusion in code, and an effective date.
Thank you. And we have our zoning administrator, Karen Gurney-Young, presenting.
Thank you, Mayor, Council members. If it's okay with the council, there are two petitions on the same topic, although one's a zoning change and one's a zoning text amendment. We'd like to group them together in one presentation, but the titles would have to be read separately and a separate vote on each one. With that, one of them is a quasi-judicial hearing. So, Mayor, if it's okay, I'll do the language on the for the quasi-judicial hearing with your permission.
Absolutely.
Thank you, sir. Tonight, we're holding a quasi-judicial hearing on the following case, ZTA 22-17 and ZC 2201 Mint Echo. This means that the commission is required by law to base its decision on the evidence contained in the record of this proceeding, which consists of the testimony at hearing, the materials which are in the official city file on this application, and any documents presented during this hearing. The City Council is also required by law to allow cross-examination of any witnesses who testify tonight. Cross-examination may occur after the staff, the applicant, and other participants have made their presentations and will be permitted in the order of the witness's appearance. It is necessary that anyone who testifies at the hearing remain until the conclusion of the hearing in order to be able to respond to any questions. All who intend to offer testimony this evening on any of the cases should be sworn in.
Should we do the swearing in at this item or at the next item?
We can do it now. We can do it now.
I'm doing them kind of together, but Christy, you tell me how you'd like to get it done.
Mayor, I think for purposes, we're doing them both sort of as quasi-judicial. The first one is just a text amendment, which is legislative. It's not quasi-judicial, but the zoning change is quasi-judicial, and since they're tied to the same property, we were just going to do it together for sake of making the presentations easier. So what I would recommend is we go ahead and swear folks in for both items. And then for purposes of approval, we'd read the title to the zoning change and then proceed with that as a separate vote.
Excellent. Thank you.
Ready? Yeah. Those who will be providing testimony, please stand and raise your right hand. Do you affirm that the testimony you are about to provide is the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth? And thank you. You may be seated.
Thank you, Mayor. As this being quasi-judicial, the petitioner is the presenter first. So with that, I will ask that the petitioner's representative come up to the dais, and I am placing their presentation right now.
Thank you, Karen. For the record, Josh Nichols with Schmidt Nichols, representing the applicant. So this evening, before we get started, I'm going to turn it over to the co-founder of Mint Eco to kind of go over what Mint Eco is, what their operation is about, because I think it is very relevant to these two requests. So with that, I'm going to turn it over real quick to Jeff Jervis, and then he'll pass it back to me in a couple minutes here.
Thank you. Good evening, everyone. Can we do the slides? Thank you. So I'll be brief. I was chastised for not being brief enough at the last hearing, but I will be brief this time. I promise that. I founded the company with a partner of mine in 2018 in order to change an industry. I believe the car wash industry generally is tremendously necessary. It's very underserved here in the county, and I believe that for the most part, car wash operators didn't do a very good job. And so what you'll see tonight is just some representations of how we approach the business differently. The first thing, we're a relationship-focused organization with four key relationships. Our first relationship is with our customers. And as you can see on the pictures up top, this is our wash on Southern Boulevard and Olive. It starts with a beautiful site. Many car washes are not beautiful, and we pride ourselves on having beautiful buildings with a tremendous amount of landscaping. If you don't mind, go to the next slide, please. Thank you. Our lobbies, you know, continued representation of this, clean, free coffee, free bottle, free water bottle fillers, immaculate bathrooms. As a matter of fact, we often find sheriff's department and local police are frequenting our sites, not only because we provide them a free car washes, but also because it's an opportunity for them to use clean bathrooms, which candidly I don't think are readily available in many of the districts. Next slide, please. Again, more pictures of what we do. The picture on the top right, that's our outdoor lobby. You know, we pride ourselves on where we can using landscaping, using trees instead of shades, using grass, using coral stone pavers, beautiful pots and flowers. Again, trying to do it differently. Next slide, please. Our second key relationship is the community, and you can see up on the slide some charities that we support locally. First thing we do when we operate a wash is we draw a 3-mile circle around the wash, and we reach out to every single educational institution, whether it be public or private, every religious organization, as well as every charitable organization inside that 3-mile circle. And we actively solicit to support them with donations. So far to date, we've given $150,000 to charities around our 3 washes that are operating right now. You'll also see the police seal up there for the Jupiter Police Department and the Palm Beach and the Sheriff's Office. And those are up there because we also offer free car washes to any police, any first responders. We believe that it's the least we can do in giving back to the community, not only our charitable offerings, but also supporting those that put themselves at risk for us. In addition, you can go to the next slide, please. Every wash, we adopt a park. This is Ocean Reef Park. We've adopted it for our Jupiter location. We haven't designated a park yet, and we'd look for some advice on what park to adopt in association with our wash on Lake Worth Road. But this is a park that we clean up at least 6 times. We try and do it at least 6 times a year. It's our local staff from our local wash, in addition to our corporate staff going out and cleaning these parks up. We want to make sure that our employees, certainly the ones that are in these washes, are aware and are participating in our community activities. Next slide, please. We've won some awards. On the left, you'll see we've won an award, the Patriot Award, as well as another award from the Department of Defense for our support of the Garden Reserve. We pride ourselves on attempting to hire as many Garden Reservists as we can, as well as we've crafted our employee manual to be very lenient and liberal with respect to leave, payment, if they're ever called to duty, as well as our support of their families. And then also we've won in 2022, we won the best car wash in Palm Beach County from the Palm Beach Post. We're also up for that same award this year, along with a new award, which is the Green Business of the Year. Next slide, please. Our third pillar relationship here is with the environment. Just so you know, the most friendly, eco-friendly thing that a car wash does, a professional car wash exists. It takes 140 gallons to wash a car in your driveway, and you use whatever chemistry's under your sink. And that water goes right into our storm drains, and as we know, our storm drains go right into our canals, into our waterways. Every drop of water that we use in our tunnel is captured. It is recycled on an 8-tank system and then reused. So we end up using about 70 gallons of water in total, of which about 40 of those are recycled. Our commitment goes well beyond that. I'll tell you, there's a long list up there. Most recently, we've added bamboo toilet paper as a better product to use, more eco-friendly. And so we do that in everywhere. All of our coffee pods are reusable. And we take our commitment to the environment very seriously. Next slide, please. Again, what's different about us? Why are we asking for the text amendment? What's different about us is what you see up on the screen right there. Again, this is our wash on Southern Boulevard, where we'll do interiors and detail services for customers. We offer free vacuums, like most modern car washes do. We have a tunnel, like most modern car washes, but we also offer the ability to, for a fee, to do the interior. You can come sit in our lobby, enjoy our free coffee, get a detail, same thing, and we believe that those services are a big differentiator in the product mix that we have. Next slide, please. Again, more pictures of our lobby. Those, again, necessary because most car washes today won't have a lobby because they're not having their customers get out of the car. Obviously, we need those services. We need those facilities available. Next slide, please. Again, our washes are different. We're staffed generally with about 20 people in the high season. We can get up to about 20 people on site at any one time. We greet personally. We hand dry cars when they come out of the tunnel. We also have quality control that delivers your car at the end. Next slide, please. And then our last relationship is with our employees. And each one of our car washes has a payroll of over $1 million. We start with line staff. Our line staff, with tips included, make $15 to $30 an hour, which is on the high end of the range for anybody who's hourly employees at a car wash. If you're good at that, we teach English classes. We offer free English classes to our employees. And if you can learn English and you're good at your job, it opens up the opportunity to become a customer service representative where you're making $25 to $35 an hour, which equates to about $50,000 to $60,000 a year. If you're good at that, you can become an assistant manager. And if you're good at assistant manager, you can have a manager. And those salaries are $50,000 to $75,000 for an assistant manager and $75,000 to $125,000 for a manager. As a matter of fact, our manager at our wash in West Palm started as a line staff member, worked his way up through our customer service staff, became an assistant manager, and is now a full-fledged manager making this year. He will make $125,000. Next slide, please. And that is my entire presentation. I just wanted to focus on our differences and let you know why the text amendment was necessary because of those detailing and interior services that we do in addition to what you'll see at most car washes. So I'll turn it back to Josh.
So again, Josh Nichols for the record. So I'm going to go over the fun stuff. So we have the two formal requests, as you know, and again, we're combining agenda item 5 and agenda item 6 for, I guess, to conserve time here. So anyways, the first one is the zoning text amendment, and basically the gist of that is to allow the outdoor detailing and waxing for standalone car washes. The second request is for the rezoning. Next slide, please. So again, for the zoning text amendment, as you know, Ordinance 2022-07, which was approved by the commission, allowed standalone car washes special exceptions. So we're utilizing that piece of that. And then also the request that came in specific to that special exception was for an express wash, so it didn't have the exterior detailing, so that was excluded from that text. So we're basically asking to add that in. If you could go to the next slide, please. So I won't go through each line of this, but the main impetus was this, was to add the exterior detailing and waxing. And what we did to mitigate that was to have a 6-foot wall that was required for screening, as well as buffering on either side of the wall. So that way there's no impacts to the adjacent property owners. Next slide. And again, we work closely with staff to develop that language, and staff is in agreement with where we've come up with. So again, there's 3 findings of fact for a zoning text amendment. The first was the reason and need. And again, we're a hybrid model, right? So we have the express side, but we also have the full detail. So we want to be able to provide that additional service through this amendment. Present text is invalid or inappropriate. So I wouldn't say that it's either. I think that it just limits you to one style where we want to have 2 different varieties to be able to offer in the town. Because again, there's other provisions within that special exception criteria that limit the number of car washes based on a separation. So you have a 3,000-foot separation, so that avoids that inundation of the use. But we want to make sure the use that we do have will have that flexibility. And then compliance with the comprehensive plan. So what we've proposed and where the location of the car wash and how it operates is consistent with the goals, objectives, and policies of the comprehensive plan, and we'll go through some of those items. Next slide. Mitigation measures. So again, car washes are still limited, obviously, to the urban arterial roadways, which in this case is Lake Worth Road. Commercial intensive zone parcels are located along these arterials, and it is the only district in which the car wash would be allowed. All car washes must comply with the 15 supplemental standards. So again, with this modification to the code, we comply with all 15 standards. And again, in the CI district, which is your commercial intensive, it requires a 6-foot wall along the residentially adjoining properties. So we have included that, as well as if it didn't have residential, it would still require that 6-foot wall for those types of uses. So you can go to the next slide. So again, this is just showing that separation requirement in the code is 3,000 feet. We're about 7,300 feet away from the nearest car wash that's actually on the agenda this evening. So hopefully these are the 2 that are basically along Lake Worth Road corridor. Next slide. So then we get into request 2. So this is the second item on the agenda that we have for Mint Eco. And this is the zoning change. So currently all 3 parcels are general commercial, and we're asking for that change to commercial intensive to support the use. Next slide. What I think is interesting on this slide is that the comprehensive plan and the zoning code both provide for these spheres of activity centers. So these are hubs along major arterials, which extend about 1,300 feet from the intersections of two major roadways within the town. So we fall directly within one of those hubs. So this is again, why the request makes sense from a comp plan and from the zoning text on the change from CG to CI. So this is where you want those primary activity centers. This is where the code and the comp plan direct that type of intensive use. Next slide. So again, I won't go into all these, but this is just to point out from the comprehensive plan as it relates to the zoning text change, that these are where the higher intensity uses are. They're located within the spheres of activity and oriented toward major highways and thoroughfares, and that's exactly where this parcel is. Next. So again, we want to turn, I'm sure everyone's been by this, the old LaGrange site. This is what it looks like now. Next slide. This is what we're trying to turn it into. So we're really trying to make the site better, make it something you guys can be proud of, that the community can utilize as a service. You can go to the next slide. And I will say Jeff and his team went personally to the community and have talked to several folks, and we were able to get two letters of support representing three parcels in the immediate vicinity abutting the property. So you can see those two letters. And I believe with that, be happy to answer any questions you may have. Appreciate the time.
All right, at this time, we're going to our... To Karen, right? To do our presentation?
Thank you, Mayor. Council members, as stated, this is two petitions. So the first one is in regards to a zoning text amendment. The second is in regards to a zoning change. So again, to kind of give you an idea, it's actually three separate parcels. The top parcel is where the vacant restaurant is located, and the two parcels to the south are presently vacant. So you can see there's residential to the west, residential to the east, and a canal, and then residential to the south. And then obviously you're right next door to the Dairy Queen. So this is what our zoning code would look like. I wanted to give you a good feel. So the pink is the CI, and the red is the CG. So it kind of gives you a feel. Lake Worth Road, without a doubt, is our commercial thoroughfare. Predominantly, if you would go further west, it's predominantly CI. So again, if the intention is to make it our major thoroughfare, you typically would want to have your CI as your type of activity allowed. The zoning text amendment is to allow a car detailing activity at a standalone car wash. Okay, so we originally had our code which only allowed car washes next to gas stations. Then we did an amendment which allowed them no longer needing to be near gas stations. And now the next request is to allow the outdoor car detailing operations. So as we've seen the proposed language, again, to address the impacts with car detailing, because the activity is outside, the thought would be you would address the noise and the activity through a wall or a fence. So that would be what would be requested. There's some flexibility in there, and I'm going to kind of give you an example. You know, in this instance, next door is the Dairy Queen. Would we want someone to have to go all the way down to the street to have to go over while they're waiting for their car to go visit the Dairy Queen? We may want to have a break in the wall that might allow somebody to go across if that's an agreement with the adjacent property owner. So we did want to give a little bit of flexibility based upon the particular situation, but it is discretionary to the staff. So it's not the applicant who has the choice, it's the city that would have the choice. So again, as we talked about, there's really two basic ones for me. It's the need and the justification for the change, and the other one is the relationship of the proposed amendment to the objectives in our comprehensive plan and how that fits in. I mean, the need and the justification is clear. The way that Mint Echo operates would not be permitted under our existing code, because they have that car detailing operation. So that's why the amendment is necessary. Does it meet our comprehensive plan? Absolutely, as was indicated. That is typically our commercial area where we have. Of course, we typically would, based upon what you saw tonight, we feel there's a market demand for this type of service. We also feel that it would give some economic opportunities, particularly the costs that are being proposed or the salaries that are being proposed by this particular applicant. Again, this is not specific. This zoning text amendment is across the board, right? It's not just for Mint Echo's parcel. This one would allow, if a standalone car wash meets all the criteria, then they would be able to also have the car detailing in their location as well. However, it is a special exception still. So it's not permitted as of right. They would still have to come to the city council to allow them to have the standalone car wash. You would have the option then to be able to say car detailing or whatever else you felt may not be appropriate. Okay. Staff has determined that the petition meets the criteria for approval of the zoning text amendment. The next one is the zoning change from commercial general to commercial intensive. Again, this is a purpose to allow a standalone car wash at this specific site, okay? Because right now, car washes are not permitted in a commercial general zoning district. They're only allowed in commercial intensive. So the criteria we need to take a look at is, we need to look at, is it contrary to land use? Is it existing land use pattern? Does it create an isolated district? Are the districts illogically drawn? And staff went through this whole analysis. The Development Review Committee all reviewed it, and we felt that all the conditions that were met were appropriate for this particular zoning change. So, for example, it's not contrary to the city's land use map. It's consistent with the existing land use pattern where we're converting these parcels to CI on Lake Worth Road. Lake Worth Road is predominantly CI. It won't overtax or increase the public facilities, keeping in mind that it was already commercial. So it's not like we're going from a vacant parcel to a commercial parcel. It was already developed. It was just vacant for a time period. So realistically, the services should have already been taken into consideration when it was first zoned into commercial general. It will not create a special privilege. There is a substantial need for this type of car wash, and we feel, again, it doesn't influence the area. It was already deemed to be commercial. So staff has also determined that this petition meets the criteria for the approval of a zoning change. The Development Review Committee met on September 9th. No objections were received regarding the proposal for either of the petitions. The Planning Zoning Board of Adjustments did review, and they recommended unanimously approval 4-0 as presented by staff. Staff is recommending approval of ZC 2201 through Ordinance 2022-36 and ZTA 22-17 through Ordinance 2022-35. This is first reading, so it is not adoption. It's just first reading, so staff is here to answer any questions. We ask that everything in our file be included as part of the public record. I will let you know, during the Planning Zoning Board of Appeal, there were some residents who did show up regarding this petition. Two items specifically were mentioned during it. Noise was one, and flooding was a second one. So I did want to let you know, flooding, really, again, the individual parcel is required to keep its own water on its own site. So really, from a perspective, this wouldn't add to the necessarily to the flooding. The noise, obviously, we're trying to address that with the screening of the wall and the fencing. But those were the ones that individuals did come in and wanted you to be aware. There were some information. I did ask the applicant to meet with them after. Certainly, you can ask what transpired between them. I think you can see they did go to some of the owners and got the letter of of no objection from some of the homeowners. So I think they did go out in good earnest to try to address any concerns people would have. With that, staff's here to answer any questions as well as the applicant.
Thank you. Are there any comments or questions from the council? Deputy Mayor Tharp.
First question, I think more so for the applicant. I saw two letters from residential neighborhood who were in approving and supporting, but I count 7, 10, 15 homes within the property boundary alone, maybe even closer to 19. So 2 of 19 seems a little skewed. So I didn't know if you also received any letters of objection or from the resident comments. Is the first concern. I know we've got tons of questions on site plan when we get to that point. So
I'll take the question. So with respect to the residents, they were all notified. And what we did was two residents showed up and expressed concern that was noted. One was about noise. The other was, the other one was about really the wall and the location of our wall and access to the site. We went out and met. We went to the community. I went to the community on three separate occasions since the Planning and Zoning Board meeting, met with not only those two residents who had expressed concerns, I only solicited letters from those two residents who had expressed concerns. I do believe I could go out and get more letters. I did want to make sure that we address their concerns, and we address their concerns, with explaining the situation to them, making some small changes to the site plan to accommodate their needs. And again, both of the residents that showed up did in fact sign letters of support, not just no objection, but letters of support for the project. I made myself available to the community, again, going out a few times. A couple other neighbors came up, had conversations. I didn't follow up with them beyond that, but to the extent any additional objections came up, we are a community-focused organization, and so we would address those as they came up. But again, to your point about the 15-plus residents, they all did receive the notices, I believe.
Josh, within 500 feet of it.
So more than that, received notices, and we just dealt with the objections that came up and made ourselves available in the community and did speak to many neighbors. As a matter of fact, spoke to two other neighbors that are, right on the property line. And again, not to put the cart before the horse here, but I do believe I could get letters of support from more should that be necessary.
No, I don't think it's necessary. It was just I wanted to make sure that besides the two letters that you didn't receive objections from any other residents.
Oh, no objections. No, sir.
Perfect. Thank you.
Councilmember Diaz.
A couple questions I have. The first is, and I probably already know this answer, but I'm assuming that the residents were notified about tonight's hearing.
Absolutely. Okay. Not only did we post it on our website and in the paper, but we also sent letters out.
Okay. What are the business hours that are proposed for the car wash?
On weekdays, 7 to 9, and then on weekends, Saturday, we go 8 to 6, and Sunday, 9 to 5.
Okay. And then the other one is, and if I missed how it's laid out, I do apologize, but seeing the parcels, where in this vicinity would the detailing portion be located on the parcel?
Can you see if I use this?
Sure.
So our operation stops about here. So this is, right, so this remains vacant, right?
Okay.
Our operation goes here, and the three vacuums are over here, right? And then our activities for detailing occur right here. Mm-hmm. And I will say that the detailing business is only open 9 to 5.
Okay. Okay, thank you.
Are there any other comments or questions from the council? No. All right, we are reverting back to item 5, which is a public hearing. At this point in time, I'd like to open public hearing for ordinance 2022-35, first reading. Anyone wishing to speak in favor of the ordinance, please come forward, state your name and address for the record. Anyone wishing to speak in opposition of the ordinance, please come forward, state your name and address for the record. Public hearing is now closed. Once again, we are talking about the text amendment, correct, on item 2235?
That's correct. Correct.
All right, do I have a motion to approve?
Motion to approve ordinance number 2022-35 on first reading.
Second.
All right, motion made by Councilmember Busquets, second by Councilmember Dugo. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
All right, that motion carries 4-0. Now we are moving on to our next item, which is a quasi-judicial public hearing for ordinance 2022-36, first reading. If I can have our city clerk please read the ordinance by title.
Ordinance 2022-36, first reading, approving a zoning change and official zoning map amendment of three parcels of land totaling approximately 3.62 acres located on the south side of Lake Worth Road, approximately 200 feet west of Empire Way at 4840 Lake Worth Road, from a City of Green Acres designation of commercial general to a City of Green Acres designation of commercial intensive, as requested by the petitioner Smiths and Nichols, agent for the owner Mitt Eco Car Wash, providing for changes to the official zoning map, repeal of conflicting ordinances, severability, and providing for an effective date.
Thank you. All right, at this point in time, I'd like to ask our council to disclose any ex parte communication. I'll start to my right, Deputy Mayor Tharp.
None.
For myself, I actually had a presentation overview with the business owner and some of his staff. Councilmember Dugo.
None.
Councilmember Diaz?
None.
Councilmember Bousquet?
None.
All right, so now we've had both of the presentations. Our staff has also presented. So are there any further questions from the council regarding the proposal on the application? Seeing none. All right, I'd like to open public hearing for quasi-judicial hearing, public hearing for ordinance 2022-36, first reading. Anyone wishing to speak in favor of the ordinance, please come forward, state your name and address for the record. Seeing no one, anyone wishing to speak in opposition of the ordinance, please come forward, state your name and address for the record.
Good evening, my name is Olga Sierra. I live in 5794 South 38th Street, Green Acres, Florida. The only thing I have is a question. What about the traffic? Labor is too hectic. Now, if we do a car wash, how are we going to do with the traffic? That's only my curiosity and my question.
Karen, I'm assuming we did a traffic study in this particular.
That is correct. It has been reviewed by the traffic engineer. It's also been reviewed by Florida Department of Transportation because Lake Worth Road is their road. In both instances, we didn't receive anything that indicated it was in violation of any ordinance or regulations that were out there.
Okay. Thank you. All right. Anyone else wishing to speak in favor or in opposition of the ordinance? Seeing no one, public hearing is now closed. All right. Do I have a motion?
Motion to approve ordinance 2022-36.
Second.
All right, I have a motion made by Councilmember Dugo, second by Deputy Mayor Tharp. All in favor?
Aye.
All right, that motion carries 4-0. All right, moving on to item 7, quasi-judicial public hearing for resolution 2022-35. If I can have our city clerk please read the ordinance by title.
Resolution 2022-35, approving the petition for a special exception to allow a standalone car wash in a commercial intensive zoning district located at 6200 Lake Worth Road, as requested by the petitioner, Dwayne Dickerson, agent for the contract purchaser Vive Investments, providing for repeal of conflict in resolutions and providing for an effective date.
All right. This is also a quasi-judicial hearing. Did everybody get sworn in the first time? Anybody else needing to get sworn in?
No, it's a different group.
Right, but I thought we did the oath at once. No. Mm-mm. All right. Let's do the oath.
Do you affirm that the testimony you're about to provide is the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth? Thank you. You may be seated.
All right. So we did the oath. We read the ordinance, the resolution. All right. If I can have our council disclose ex parte communication, Deputy Mayor Tharp.
None.
None for myself. Councilmember Dugo.
None.
Councilmember Diaz.
None.
Councilmember Bousquet.
None.
All right. At this point in time, I'd like to ask the applicant to come to the podium, state your name and address for the record, and begin your presentation, please.
Good evening. Dwayne Dickerson on behalf of the applicant, attorney with the law firm Dene Miskon Backman, offices at 14 Southeast 4th Street in Boca Raton, Florida. Thank you. Next slide, please. So the subject site is on the south side of Lake Worth Road, just east of Jog Road, as you can see in the red box on the screen. Next slide, please. This is a zoom in. The site is just under an acre and a half. It's currently zoned commercial intensive, and it has commercial future land use. The existing use is a vacant restaurant, and we're proposing a standalone automated car wash facility. You can also see the adjacent uses there. The Sonic is just to our west, and the Green Acres Bowling Alley is just to our east. Next slide, please. The vacant restaurant was the Steak and Shake. I'm sure you all pass it quite a bit. The site is definitely in need of some TLC, so we're looking forward to demolishing this building, as you see, and building the new car wash facility. We don't own the site yet. We have it under contract, but we did work with your city to board it up to make sure that it's safe. So all the boarding up is taking place with our effort, but we're really looking forward to demolishing that building and moving forward with the development. Next slide, please. As you may recall, I was before you in May of this year requesting text amendment approval to allow for the standalone car wash. As your staff stated, you used to have a requirement that it was tied to a gas station, and this commission did, or council rather, did approve that change. So that allowed us to move forward our next application, which is, next slide, please. Thank you, which is our special exception and site plan approval to allow for the car wash facility, which is just shy of 4,000 square feet. And that's the request this evening. Next slide, please. So this is our site plan, just to give you orientation. The top of the screen is north, and to the left is west, to the right is east, and on the bottom is the south. We are utilizing the existing access road that's just to the west of the site, so we are not asking for any additional curb cuts or access openings onto Lake Worth Road. We are using the existing access point, which was approved by Florida Department of Transportation because they do have jurisdiction over Lake Worth Road. That was also approved by the county, Palm Beach County, as well as the city of Green Acres. So the way the site functions is you enter off of the existing access road, and then you enter into the site to the east, and then you make that right, and you can see the cars show the stacking. So that's approximately 22 cars of stack on the site with zero conflicts adjacent with that adjacent access road and nowhere near Lake Worth Road. So as you can imagine, the goal is to make sure that your site operates fully within the confines of our parcel and no spillage off of our parcel onto adjacent rights-of-way or adjacent properties. That 22-car stack is very conservative. As you can see, we have more room on our site, but that just shows that there's more than sufficient stacking. There are multiple pay stations, so to move efficiently, to make sure the cars move through efficiently. And as we have a surplus of parking, your code requires 6 parking spaces. We have 23. Provided. So everything on this site is in excess with respect to design to make sure that it functions properly. So then once you enter on the south side of the building, you then exit on the north side, and then you make that left, and then you can utilize our parking, our vacuum spaces, which are, you see those parking spaces, those are all free vacuum. So you can exit if you're not going to vacuum, and if you do vacuum, you go further south, and then you exit back onto Lake Worth Road. Next slide, please. This is our landscape plan. So consistent with the text amendment, the staff wanted to make sure that the adjacent properties are thoroughly screened and protected, and we are doing that with this plan. So you'll see on our south side and our east side, which are the closest sides to the residential community, there will be a 6-foot-high masonry solid wall, as well as on the north side, which is where you would exit the car wash. We are proposing a green screen there so that that area exiting the car wash and the tunnel will be screened from view from Lake Worth Road. I'm not a landscape architect, but when I work with our landscape architects, I say I want to see a lot of circles on the plan because circles mean trees and landscape cover and material. So you can see there are significant landscaping and circles throughout this site. It's more than exceeds your code requirements with respect to landscaping. Trees, ground cover, hedges, and everything else, in addition to the green screen and the 6-foot-high masonry wall. Next slide, please. This is a copy of our floor plan. So to orient you, north is to the left now, and south to the right, east is on top, and west on the bottom. So you can see the tunnel on the top side where the vehicles enter, and then on that west side or the bottom side, there's a office to the right. In the middle is an equipment room, and to the left is a supply room. So just functional spaces for the use of the facility. We do have between 1 to 2 employees on site at all times during operating hours to make sure that if anything happens, there's an issue with the pay station or anything, mechanical issues, there's somebody on site at all times to make sure that that's resolved immediately. Next slide, please. These are our elevations. So the top elevation is the west elevation. In the middle on the left is the north elevation. That's the elevation from Lake Worth Road. But remember, that elevation is screened with a green wall. And then on the right, in the middle, is our south elevation. And then on the bottom would be our east elevation. Next slide, please. Thank you. So just to give you a little bit of background about the principles behind the Pink Bird Car Wash franchise, they are local. They multi-generational family in Palm Beach County. They are the owners and the operators, so they will be here. Their headquarters is in Palm Beach County in West Palm Beach. And all of their profits and charitable efforts remain in the local community. So as you can imagine, having owners and operators that are local to this community gives them a huge sense of pride in making sure that this is done the right way and that it continues to operate the right way once it's built. They make sure that they provide significant value to this community with competitive pricing, a very strong commitment to quality. Convenience is key in this world. The facility usually operates with an efficiency of 3 to 5 minutes through the car wash cycle and exit into then the self-service vacuums. Very family-friendly, making sure that the site is safe and a welcoming atmosphere to all customers. Lighting and those types of design criteria, they call it SEPTED, which working with your police department, making sure you're designing the site in a way that is very safe and friendly for all customers. And then very community-oriented, they work with a group of Vita Nova, which more than 50% of their employees are former foster care and other homeless youth. So they want to make sure that we're employing folks that really need an opportunity and that come from this community. Next slide, please. They employ all the modern technology to make sure that everything's efficient, it's affordable, and that they have minimal to no impacts on the environment. I didn't share notes with the previous applicant, Josh. He's right. His number is exactly what the industry says, that the typical home wash uses about 140 gallons, right, per vehicle. And with our facility, that number is reduced to about 30 gallons per vehicle. So our water reclamation system allows for a reduction of water consumption of about 75% versus a home wash or traditional wash. And then pursuant to your code of ordinances, we are required to recapture all of our water and reuse it, which we do. So we make sure that we're reducing the need for fresh water. And, of course, we make sure that we use chemicals that are non-acidic, phosphate-free, and biodegradable. So all the latest technology is being implemented in this design. Next slide, please. Thank you. So as you know, this special exception is here this evening. Staff is recommending approval of the special exception, and we did go before your Planning and Zoning Board earlier this month, and they are unanimously recommending approval as well. Next slide. And same with the site plan. Staff is fully recommending approval, and your Planning and Zoning Board unanimously recommended approval as well. Next slide, please. So with that, I just want to once again state our excitement with this project. This is the last phase. I'm sure staff will state, but just for the record, I know there was just a typo in the backup materials that said that we had to go to a final reading. This is the final approval because this is a resolution. So we only need one hearing before the City Council. So we have also had significant outreach to the residential community adjacent to us, Seminole Palms, significant conversations and meetings and so forth, just making sure that all of the buffers and all of the landscaping and all of the design elements are done in a way to reduce or eliminate any impacts to our adjacent community. So with that, I'm happy to answer any questions, and I think staff is going to present as well.
Thank you. All right, so now we're moving on to our zoning administrator, Karen Garner-Young, to do her presentation.
Thank you, Mayor and Council. As stated, this is hand-in-hand, so they need to do a special exception first because car washes are not as permitted as of right. So we do the special exception and the site plan. Unlike the previous one, you'll be seeing theirs later. So this is exactly right. Two resolutions. If you approve it tonight, they've been deemed approved. No further review needs to be done.
and it is site plan approval for 6200 Lake Worth Road. So this is site specific. Both of these, it's a special exception for 6200 Lake Worth Road, and it's a site plan for 6200 Lake Worth Road. So again, to kind of give you where the site is, I know you've already seen it. Green Acres Bowl on one side, Lazy Boy was the original. The Montessori School is there. I will tell you that during the presentation at the Planning and Zoning Board of Appeals that some individuals from the Montessori School did show up. Their concern was the traffic since they have a joint or shared access, ingress and egress. Again, let you know what went through the traffic engineers. They don't pretend to be one, but it went through their review and they determined that it did meet whatever criteria was necessary to allow this particular use, keeping in mind that we're not changing the zoning district and it was already commercial in nature. So again, keep in mind it wasn't a vacant parcel, but it does have, it does change the use a little bit. So we looked at the ingress egress, FDOT, and as well as the city's traffic engineer approved it. It does have the enhanced screening and buffering. Again, the intention was we didn't want the opening, the car wash opening, to be what you see as you drive by on Lake Worth Road. So as we're talking about enhanced landscaping, it does do that. It does meet the yard open space requirements. It does have the refuge service area. Utilities will not be affected. Off-street parking loading, it does meet. The use won't be nuisance factor. Again, it remains commercial. The site exterior lighting it meets, it's consistent with the district regulations, it's compatible with adjoining properties, and it's not at a scale with the needs of the neighborhood. We did determine it does meet the criteria for the special exception use, so staff is recommending approval for the special exception. We also have a site plan approval to construct a 3,945 square foot car wash building. It includes 23 parking spaces, the landscape buffer, the 6-foot masonry wall, and access through the Lake Worth Road with the joint access. The lot itself was grandfathered in, and we did make a point, and I do want you to be aware, we do have what we call a transitional zone. Transitional zone is actually kind of like an overlay between residential and commercial parcels. And the intention is to make the regulations a little stricter because you want less impact on your residential neighborhood. So, for example, the setback, instead of being in a CI, which might be 20 feet, it's 50 feet. So it gives it that type of distance. In this case, staff did take a look at it, and the reason why this is being brought up is that when the Steak and Shake was developed, the entrance area where Seminole Palms is now was part of the commercial. But when Seminole Palms came in, they needed ingress off of Lake Worth Road, so actually that section got sold off. So that's what created the problem with the transitional zone. So I do want to point, we pointed it out, I want to make sure this council is aware that although the site plan does not meet the stated requirements of the transitional area regulations, we believe it does meet the intent. If you look, and I will go back again if you so desire, the ingress egress has no houses. There's a landscape buffer on the Seminole Palms end that I think the closest house is like 161 feet away. So I think the intention was that the transitional zone is there, but the commercial activity wouldn't have such impact on residential units because they're not located in that particular area. But we just wanted to make sure you were aware of that fact. The yard, the floor area, height, parking, landscaping, they meet all of those. And then the vacuuming itself also has some enhanced landscaping. I do want to point out it's not something we didn't just look at it. We have conditions of approval. And I just want you to be aware some of these are condition of approval. They got to pay fees into our public arts program, our tree dedication program, and our impact fees. They're required to have all outside agency approvals. So South Florida Water Management District, Lake Worth Drainage District, Florida Department of Transportation, the Health Department, because we're changing. They're moving the building. Okay, they're not using the same location. They're going to raise it, and they're going further east. So there will be some changes to some of the piping. And then we do have the site improvements where we have underground utilities, the masonry wall. They're required to keep existing trees as much as possible. And I did want to make sure that we did put a bike rack in there because we're off of Lake Worth Road, and it should have multimodal use. So we want to make sure that's in there. The petitioner has reviewed the conditions of approval, and they had no objections. So staff also determined that this petition meets the criteria for the approval of a site plan. The Development Review Committee met on March 10th and 17th, and any staff comments were incorporated into the staff report. We are recommending approval with the 27 conditions outlined in the September 27th, 2022 Development Review Committee report and recommendation. As far as the PZAB, they did meet on December 8th, 2022, and unanimously approved approval 4-0 as presented by staff, including all the conditions of approvals as outlined. Staff is here to answer any questions or comments you may have. We ask that everything in our file be included as part of the public record.
There are any comments or questions from the council? Deputy Mayor Tharp.
First, thank you for the enhanced landscaping. I certainly appreciate it. The two noisiest pieces that I foresee is going to be the exit of the gas station or the car wash, and the outdoor vacuums. So the outdoor vacuums are going to be on the closest to Lake Worth Road. Is that correct?
Yes. Let's get the site plan so we have it. Let's get this down. There you go. So the vacuums are going to be in this area.
Am I seeing?
Yeah. Let me know if I'm going wrong, but I believe this is the area that the vacuums will be located. So you have in the back area here, this is all landscaping. This is the retention area that they have. And again, the residential is probably the closest one is down in this area over here. Okay.
So what is the distance between the outdoor vacuums and the closest home?
Let's see if we did that.
Approximately.
I want to make sure. Let's see.
Was it from
we had 161 feet is what we had in the staff report.
Is that from the vacuums or from the car wash?
I would probably say it's from the car wash. So maybe I would say maybe 141, maybe if we have to. It's not that close. And I think the house is actually over on this side. It's on the other side of the roadway.
Mm-hmm. And I guess last question for the applicant. It sounds like you did some public engagement as well. Same question I asked the other applicant. Everyone always reports the positives. Did you receive any negative feedback from residents?
We did not. We did not receive anything negative. And I spoke to staff as late as this morning, and they had not received anything negative either. And if I may, I did want to answer one question with respect to the vacuums. The good news is the actual point of vacuum doesn't really make the noise. It's the engines that drive the vacuums, and those are located on the right top right there. So those are far away from the community, and we did that on purpose. But the actual point of vacuum isn't really where the activity comes from. It comes from the engines, and those are as far away as possible.
No, perfect. Thank you.
Councilmember Diaz.
Hi, it's for the applicant. If you could just reiterate, what did I hear you say it's a 24-hour?
No.
Okay, good.
No.
what are your hours of operation?
Like I said, I did not promise you. I didn't compare notes with the other application. We're the same, about 7 a.m. to about 9 p.m. You know, as daylight savings changes, that may change a bit by demand, but that's general, 7 a.m. to 9 p.m.
And those vacuums, once you're shut down, those are shut down
as
well?
100%.
Okay.
You know, the older generation, you could go at 3 in the morning, and that doesn't work that way. The facility only operates during operating hours.
Perfect. Thank you.
Thank you.
And just to clarify, this one is not asking for the car detailing. So it will only be the vacuuming. And again, the hours are in the condition of approval. So if they change those for any reason or go beyond it, it's a violation of the condition of approval. And no outdoor speakers. So they're not allowed to do any of that on either one, just so you know.
Thank you.
Is there any other comments or questions from the council? All right. Thank you so much. All right. At this point in time, I'd like to open public hearing for... Where am I? All right. Public hearing for Resolution 2022-35. Anyone wishing to speak in favor of the resolution, please come forward, state your name and address for the record. Anyone wishing to speak in opposition of the resolution, please come forward, state your name and address for the record. Seeing none, public hearing is now closed.
Make a motion to approve Resolution 2022-35.
Second.
All right, I have a motion made by Deputy Mayor Tharp, second by Councilmember Bousquet. All in favor?
Aye.
All right, that motion carries 4-0. All right, moving on to resolution 2022-40. If I can have our city clerk please read the resolution by title.
Resolution 2022-40, approving a site and development plan to allow for a standalone car wash in a commercial intensive zoning district. Located at 6200 Lake Worth Road, as requested by the petitioner, Dwayne Dickerson, agent for the contract purchaser, Vibe Investments, LLC, providing for appeal of conflicting resolutions and providing for an effective date.
And once again, we have our zoning administrator, Karen Gurney-Young, presenting.
This was a combination from the last one. We've already made the presentation. Unless there's something else that we can answer or provide, I'm happy to do so.
Excellent. Are there any other comments or questions from the council?
I'd like to make a motion to approve resolution 2022-40.
Second.
Excuse me. All right. I have a motion by Councilmember Bousquet, second by Deputy Mayor Tharp. All in favor?
Aye.
All right. That motion. If I can ask everybody to speak into the mic because I can't hear everybody, but I believe that was 4-0. Any opposed? Nope. All right. That motion carries 4-0. All right. Moving on to public hearing for ordinance 2022-39. First reading, if I can have our city clerk please read the ordinance by title.
Ordinance 2022-39. First reading, amending the future land use map of the future land use element of the city's comprehensive plan to change the future land use designation of one parcel of land totaling approximately 20.1183 acres located at the southeast corner of Lake Worth Road and Jog Road at 6400 and 6490 Lake Worth Road and 4180 South Jog Road, Suites 1 through 9 from a Palm Beach County designation commercial high to a City of Green Acres designation of commercial as requested by the Planning, GIS, and Engineering Division, providing for repeal of conflicting ordinances, providing for severability, providing for transmittal to the Division of Community Development, providing for inclusion in comprehensive plan, and providing for an effective date.
Thank you. And once again, we have Zoning Administrator Karen Gurney-Young presenting.
Thank you, Mayor and City Council. If it's with your permission, I'd like to do this jointly. Again, it's one of those petitions that it's a land use amendment and a zoning change on the same parcel. So I'll do the same presentation, but you would have to read the two titles in separately since they're two different type of actions to be taken. So I'm sure this is a long time coming. That's usually what we hear when I bring up Lake Worth Plaza West. So this is actually short time since the annexation. So again, this is Lake Worth Plaza West. This is the property site. It's located on the southeast corner of Lake Worth Road and Jog Road. As you know, we recently annexed the property in from Palm Beach County. This is just the base portion. It's not the out parcels. The out parcels we had to do through a different process. We didn't want to wait. We felt it was appropriate to bring it in so that way we could start to create the relationship with the tenants who are presently there, making sure that they're in compliance with the city's land use and zoning code, because until this happens, they're under Palm Beach County. So the first one is we need a land use amendment. It is a city request. We need to change from Palm Beach County Commercial High. Unlike us, we only have one commercial designation when it comes to land use. You're commercial, you're residential. But in Palm Beach County, they have multiple levels. So we're asking to change from Palm Beach County High to city commercial. And again, the reason is we need to do it due to the recent annexation. So this is what it would look like. This is our proposed land use map. As you can see, the site is the pink. Pink is commercial. To the south is PI, which is the post office. Okay, so that's why it's public. And then, of course, CM, commercial on the top. We have RSHD and RSMD. Part of that is the apartment complexes. Taking a look at it, it is appropriate. It already had a commercial designation. We're keeping it as a commercial designation. It doesn't make it any less or any more intensive, particularly on the land use, because this is the only designation that we particularly have. Staff took a look at the items in regards to three items: compatibility, concurrency, and consistency. So compatibility already showed you the map that the area really is predominantly commercial along that entire parcel. Again, it affronts Jog Road and it affronts Lake Worth Road. We feel that it does have the concurrency. It already had the services that were being provided when it was in the Palm Beach County. The only change is that, you know, we'd be providing typically the fire and the police. So the police, we go from one district to the other district, right, because we have the sheriff's office already. The fire department, as you well know, is under an agreement. So over time, it will eventually convert over to Green Acres Fire Department. But again, we feel that the services are concurrent. We feel it is consistent with our comprehensive plan. Again, we talked about the nodes. We talk about Lake Worth Road is meant to be commercial in nature. It's all outlined in the staff report and indicating that we do feel that it determined that it does meet the criteria for the approval of a land use amendment. So the second one is the zoning change. So once we change it to a city land use, we now need to change it to a zoning land use. They have, it presently has Palm Beach County Commercial General. So the thought would be, well, why wouldn't it be the city commercial general? Well, Palm Beach County doesn't align directly with what ours is. Actually, the Palm Beach County Commercial General aligns with our commercial intensive. So that's why we're recommending commercial intensive. But again, that really is in compliance with our comprehensive plan that indicates on Lake Worth Road we would typically have commercial intensive. The need for the zoning change, of course, is due to the recent annexation that came in. Here, again, is to give you what the zoning looks like. So the pink is your CI, the red is your commercial general, and then you have the GU, the post office, and then behind is your higher level type residential. So it's typically not single family. This would be the type of usage you would typically have when you kind of step down as you go through from a commercial nature down to the next potential residential level. We did take a look at the different items. You have to look whether the change would be contrary to our land use, the land use pattern. We talked about all these in the zoning. We went through each one of these. We feel that it is consistent in regards to the zoning change. Nothing there really brought a concern to staff. And I think part of the reason, again, is that it was already commercial. We're not recommending any changes per se than what was already there. And if we were able to provide the services and provide everything, then it only makes sense due to the annexation that they need the city's designation. Staff has determined that the petition does meet the criteria for the approval of a zoning change. Development Review Committee met on November 17, 2022. We had no objections to what was being perceived. I did provide all the information to the property owner. He is aware. He has no objections to what's being presented. As a matter of fact, his response was, well, you're moving really fast on this. So I said, well, we try our best. Planning Zoning Board of Adjustments did meet on December 8th and unanimously recommended approval for zero of both petitions as presented by staff. We are recommending approval of the small scale. This is a small scale, even though it's 20 acres, small scale land use amendment, CPA 2202 through Ordinance 2022-39 and zoning change CZ 2202 through Ordinance 2022-40. This is first reading, so it is not final. We have to come back to you on adoption. We ask that everything in our file be included as part of the public record, and staff is here to answer any questions or comments you may have.
Are there any comments or questions from the council? All right, seeing none, I'd like to open public hearing for Ordinance 2022-39, first reading. Anyone wishing to speak in favor of the ordinance, please come forward, state your name and address for the record. Seeing none, anybody wishing to speak in opposition of the ordinance, please come forward, state your name and address for the record. Seeing none, public hearing is now closed.
I'd like to make a motion to approve Ordinance 2022-39.
Second.
Oh, I'm sorry, I'm first reading.
All right, a motion made by Councilmember Diaz, second by Councilmember Bousquet. All in favor?
Aye.
All right, that motion carries 4-0. All right, moving on to Ordinance 2022-40, first reading. If I can have our city clerk please read the ordinance by title.
Ordinance 2022-40, first reading, approving a zoning change for one parcel of land totaling approximately 20.1183 acres located at the southeast corner of Lake Worth Road and Jog Road at 6400 and 6490 Lake Worth Road and 4180 Jog Road, Suites 1 through 9, from a Palm Beach County zoning designation of general commercial to a City of Green Acres zoning designation of commercial intensive as requested by the Planning, GIS, and Engineering Division, providing for changes to the official zoning map, providing for repeal of conflicting ordinances, providing for severability, and providing for an effective date.
Thank you. And we just had our zoning administrator, Karen Garner-Young, present. Are there any comments or questions from the council? All right, seeing none, do I have a motion?
Motion to approve Ordinance 2022-40, first reading.
Second.
All right, I have a motion made by Deputy Mayor Tharp, second by Councilmember Bousquet. All in favor?
Aye.
All right, that motion carries 4-0. All right, we are now moving on to public hearing for ordinance 2022-38, second reading. If I can have our city clerk please read the ordinance by title.
Ordinance 2022-38, second reading, amending Chapter 6, Franchises, Article 5, Solid Waste, Division 1, General Section 6-276 of the City of Green Acres Code of Ordinances to clarify that all rates under the franchise agreement may be amended by city resolution providing for repeal of conflicting ordinances, severability, codification, retrospective application, and an effective date.
Thank you. And we have Director of Purchasing, Monica Powery, presenting.
Good evening, Mr. Mayor and Council. This is the second reading for Ordinance 2022-38. As we stated last time, the purpose is to clarify that all rates under the Solid Waste Franchise Agreement must be made through City Resolution. City Council heard this item on December 5th and unanimously approved this item with no changes. Staff is recommending adoption of Ordinance 2022-38.
Thank you. Are there any comments or questions from the council?
I'd like to make a motion to approve Ordinance 2022-38 on second reading.
It's second.
Public.
Oh.
Oh.
Sorry.
It was my fault. I'd like to open public hearing for Ordinance 2022-38. Anyone wishing to speak in favor of the ordinance, please come forward, state your name and address for the record. Seeing no one, anyone wishing to speak in opposition, please come forward, state your name and address for the record. Seeing no one, public hearing is now closed. I have a motion made by Councilmember Diaz, second by Councilmember Dugo. All in favor?
Aye.
All right, that motion carries 4-0. All right, moving on to public hearing for Ordinance 2022-42. Second reading, if I can have our city clerk please read the ordinance by title.
Ordinance 2022-42, second reading, amending Chapter 2, Administration, Article 1 in general by adding a new Section 2-2, naming of city programs, events, and facilities, providing for severability, conflicts, codification, and an effective date.
All right. We have our city manager, Andrew McHugh, presenting.
Thank you, Mayor, City Council. The council had discussed and was interested in having a policy and or procedure in place to assist in determining how programs, events, and facilities, including property, are named. The city attorney prepared an ordinance creating a new section in the city's code of ordinances, which established a uniform method and procedure for the naming of city programs, events, and facilities. The naming authority is solely vested in the city council, and through the adoption of the ordinance, a process will be established for naming of our programs, events, and or facilities. Based on direction that was received at the last council meeting, the ordinance has been updated to reflect that 4 votes will be required for the naming and or removing or renaming of any programs, events, and or facilities. Staff is recommending approval of Ordinance 2022-42 on second reading.
Are there any comments or questions from the council?
I'd like to make a motion to approve.
Is it public hearing?
This is a public hearing.
2022-42 on the second reading.
Second.
There's a public hearing.
All right. This is a public hearing. So are there any other comments or questions from the council? Seeing none, I'd like to open public hearing for Ordinance 2022-42, second reading. Anyone wishing to speak in favor of the ordinance, please come forward, state your name and address for the record. Seeing none, anyone wishing to speak in opposition of the ordinance, please come forward, state your name and address for the record. Public hearing is now closed. I have a motion made by Councilmember Bousquet, second by
Dugo.
Councilmember Dugo. All in favor?
Aye.
All right, that motion carries 4-0. All right, moving on to Ordinance 2022-41, first reading. If I can have our city clerk please read the ordinance by title.
Ordinance 2022-41, first reading, approving the conveyance of 6,804 square feet strip of land located adjacent to and east of the property at 1105 South Jog Road, Green Acres, Florida, authorizing city manager to execute all documents necessary to accomplish the conveyance, providing for severability, conflicts, and an effective date.
All right, and we have our zoning administrator, Karen Gurney-Young, presenting.
I promise this is the last one. Good evening. Thank you, Mayor, City Council. This is actually a request to purchase city property. I want you to note that it is requires 2 readings, so it's not final tonight, but I wanted to bring forward to you, the applicant is here to answer any questions that you may have. But if you see on the map, I wanted to give you an idea where it's located. The parcel actually is the parcel, and I'm going to show you the next slide, that's a little sliver that's right next to Jog Road. So this is actually what the purchase property is, but the applicant actually has property behind there, and the reason for the request was because they felt that they could create a better product if they were able to take the additional property that was located in the front. So again, this just kind of gives you the idea of kind of what it looks like. The gray on the top here, this is Jog Road. The applicant's request is for the city to sell 6,804 square feet of land, which is fronting Jog Road. We did a complete search to make sure that the city does own the property. We believe we do. The applicant approached the city on the sale so that it can be added to a proposed plan development. There's no application in my hand, so I can't tell you what it is. But the offer is for $17,500, including all closing costs, which is title and taxes. The applicant actually already paid for an appraisal, so the costs have been particularly incurred by the applicant. The process itself requires two readings of an ordinance, so that is why this is first reading tonight. If you approve it after second reading, what you're allowing is the city council will authorize the city manager to execute any documents on behalf of the city. But you're approving the purchase, you're approving the purchase price. Now, staff is recommending approval based upon the fact that the adjacent owner is really the only person who could buy the property. It really doesn't have any developmental right or value, so city staff does believe the selling of the property is in the best interest of the public health, safety, and welfare of the city. We are here to answer any questions or comments that you may have.
Are there any comments or questions from the council? Deputy Mayor Tharp.
I agree. I mean, it's a small piece of property. Is there any need for us doing an appraisal? I mean, again, I don't see anybody else ever wanting to buy that, but want to make sure that we're just getting fair value.
We already did the appraisal. That was before it even came in because we didn't even know what price would be appropriate. I think that's really in the public interest. You generally do that as an independent person comes in with knowledge of the real estate area. Gives you some idea. In this case, it is different than what the appraisal was. Again, the thought here is I think they expanded it more than probably what it should have been. It really, like you said, basically it's a strip of land. There's no other purpose you could use it for. And so we felt it could add value to the proposed plan development that could be coming in.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
So what did the appraisal come in at?
I think it came in at 115, I think is what it came in, 115,000. So it is substantially more than the 17.5 being asked for by the applicant. We did raise it. Look, we didn't take the initial request that came in. But when we really took a look at it and looked at what the appraiser was doing, and I think if you understand how they do their work, they look at the highest and best possible use of it. And when you really look at it from a practical sense, there really is no use for it. I mean, who else would want to purchase it from the city? It's not big enough to develop anything. You can't put anything on it. The county gave it up, so the county doesn't need it for any right-of-way or anything that they may want on Jog Road. So our feeling was, you know, if it made a better project and, it really didn't have an impact on the city, we felt we would recommend that it should be considered for selling.
And Mayor, I can address that as well. When you look at the appraisal report that they did, what the appraiser did, because there's not really comparative properties that the appraiser could use, so the appraiser looked at the total value of the adjacent property owner, the buyer's property, and did like a pro rata assessment of how much this parcel would cost if it was already included in the overall size of the buyer's current property. And that's how they reached this $100,000 plus amount. But realistically looking at it, the city doesn't have other viable buyers for this property because the really only use for it is to be part of the overall property. We thought that the buyer's offer that we negotiated to 17.5 was probably the most the city will get for the property, including all closing costs. The city received this property for free from Palm Beach County because it was unnecessary right-of-way that the county had.
Thank you. Are there any other comments or questions from the council? All right. Does anybody want to make a motion?
Motion to approve Ordinance 2022-41 on first reading.
Second.
All right. Motion by Deputy Mayor Tharp, second by Councilmember Dugo. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
I counted three. Anybody opposed?
I'm sorry.
All right. All right, that motion carries 4-0. You okay, Councilmember Buscay?
Yeah, I'm okay, thank you.
Want to take a break?
No, I'm good.
Okay. All right, moving on to Ordinance 2022-43, first reading. If I can have our city clerk please call, please read the ordinance by title.
Ordinance 2022-43, first reading, amending the City of Green Acres budget for the fiscal year beginning October 1, 2022, and ending September 30, 2023, inclusive, providing for repeal of conflicting ordinances, providing for severability, and providing for an effective date.
All right. And we have our Director of Finance, Terry Berger, presenting.
Good evening, Mayor, City Council, Terry Lee Berger, Finance Director. Council policy number 6 requires that the City Council authorizes budget adjustments between cost centers, departments, and funds. We have three projects in our 306 fund that needs a budget adjustment. They need additional funding. And when I say additional funding, I think we can pull it from the fund balance to pay for this. But we do need an authorized budget adjustment. And the three projects are the sidewalk project and the septic to sewer project. These two have the same vendor, and the cost has increased on these two projects. The sidewalk project has increased by $33,000. When I say that, we have some savings in some of the other lines in that project that we only need approximately $33,000 to finish that one. And then the septic to sewer has increased. We need about $105,000 on that one. The third project is one of our own. When we now have to do, when we do a project on one of our own projects, we have to issue ourselves a permit. And so it is an expense to that project. And when we did our Dillman project, we did not budget for that expense. So that was a $12,402 expense. So the total budget adjustment for all three of these projects would be $150,402. Staff recommends approval of Ordinance 2022-43 on first reading. Are there any questions?
Yes, the permitting one. Who are we paying?
Who are we paying? We're paying ourselves. We are paying ourselves, yes.
Excellent, okay.
Yeah, but because it is an expense, it does increase our budget.
Accounting, okay, yeah. Got it. Mm-hmm. Is there any comments or questions from the council? My question on the septic to sewer, what has increased?
It's mainly the cost of concrete.
Concrete?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. I see no questions.
Motion. Motion to approve Ordinance 2022-43.
Second.
All right. I have a motion made by Councilmember Dugo, second by Councilmember Buscay. All in favor?
Aye.
All right. That motion carries 4-0. All right, moving on to Resolution 2022-62. If I can have our city clerk please read the resolution by title.
Resolution 2022-62, agreement between the City of Green Acres and Painting Inc. to create public art on a wall on the northeast corner of Malaluka Lane and Haverhill Road, authorizing the appropriate city officials to execute the agreement, providing for an effective date.
All right, I've been waiting for this one. Director of Purchasing, Monica Power, presenting.
Good evening, Mr. Mayor and City Council. Tonight I'm presenting Resolution 2022-62, award of the agreement between the City and Painted Inc. to create public art on the wall located on the corner of Malaluka Lane and Haverhill Road. The wall is approximately 506 feet in length and 4 feet tall. The City put out an RFP and went through the entire selection process. And this is the artist that we selected. It's her name is, she goes by Nico. She was our highest ranked artist. She's represented by Painted INC. Nico is a Florida-based visual artist and a muralist. She grew up in Palm Beach County, attending Bach Middle School of the Arts and Dreyfus High School of the Arts. She later moved to Jacksonville to study at the University of North Florida. And there's a little bit more bio here on her. But here are just a few of her murals from her portfolio. I wanted to present these to you just so that you can see what her experience and capabilities are. And now for the fun part. The following is a conceptual mock-up piece of what the artist is proposing for our area. There may still be some changes to this concept, animals, flowers, colors, but this is the general idea of what she is thinking for this area. Staff desires to approve Resolution 2022-62 and award RFP for public art. If you have any questions, I'm prepared to answer them.
I'd like to make a motion to approve Resolution 2022-62. Thank you, Mrs. Power.
Thank you. This
artwork is beautiful.
It has been such a fun project to work on.
I will second. And are we going to see concepts at some point, or is this the concept? I love the colors.
You do love the colors?
It's bright. It's vibrant. It's going to add a little bit of splash on that corner. I think it's going to be fantastic.
All right, so I have a motion made by Councilmember Bousquet, second by Deputy Mayor Tharp. Are there any other comments or questions from the council? My only comment is the snake. I'm not a fan of the snake.
Neither is Andrea.
Neither was I. I didn't love the snake either.
If we can get some other animals, turtle. I'm a big fan of turtle.
Proposed a turtle.
We need like a loggerhead or something. I don't know, something that's native to Florida.
We got the squirrel.
We got the squirrel. We got the gator.
I was going to say the alligator freaked me out, but
yeah. But if we can get the snake and get some like a turtle or something, that would be really nice. That's my.
You don't want to know.
That being said, I think it's going to be beautiful. Whatever, it's going to be better than a bare concrete wall.
Yes, if you stop and you look at her previous art, her murals, I mean, so impressed. Very, very impressed with her. I think it's going to be great.
Sorry, any other comments?
Estimated start date or completion date?
As soon as possible, since we're technically in the dry season.
No, two thumbs up, all four.
All right, so I have a motion made by Councilmember Bousquet, second by Deputy Mayor Tharp. All in favor?
Aye.
All right, that motion carries 4-0. Oh,
that's such a long time.
All right, moving to our next item, ratification of the Building Board of Adjustments and Appeal Board. We are appointing one of nine members to serve 4-year unlimited staggered terms. We have a presentation by City Manager Andrew McHugh.
Thank you, Mayor, City Council. As you stated, Mayor, six members have already been appointed. This is just adding one additional member to complete the regular members. There will still be two alternate vacancies. That one member is a general contractor and also in real estate. His name is Brandon Cabrera. Staff is recommending ratification of the Building Board of Adjustment and Appeals appointment.
Any comments or questions from the council? Do I have a motion?
Motion.
All right. Do I have a second?
Second.
All right. I have a motion made by Councilmember Dugo, second by Deputy Mayor Tharp. All in favor?
Aye.
All right. That motion carries 4-0. Moving on to discussion items, there are none tonight. Comments from the public on non-agenda items, please come forward, state your name and address for the record.
Okay. Olga Sierra from 5794 South 38th Street, Green Acre, Florida, 33463. Okay, I just want to bring two concerns that I have. The first one is, if it's possible, the Public Works Department clean the sewers vents, because all the leaves from our trees in the front of our house ended up there, and when it rains, it flows the streets. The perfect example is 37 Court. I was coming the other night from work. I always usually took 37 to get to 38th Street. That's my street. And it was flooded. Why? Because the sewer drains are tapped with the leaves. That's one of my concerns. The second concern is the big holes that we have in the corners, that because they fix the sidewalks, and at the end of the sidewalks in the corners, there are huge holes. What they do is they put just dirt on it, and when the cars make the turn in the, you know, in the streets, they make the hole bigger. So that's my major concern, to see instead of putting dirt, why you don't put cement in there. That's my other two concerns that I have. And the potholes are in the 37 court when you enter.
Okay. Thank you.
Welcome.
Thank you, Olga. Can we take notes of that?
Yep.
Thank you. Anyone else wishing to speak? All right. Seeing none. Moving on to our city manager's report. City Manager McHugh.
Thank you, Mayor. Only a couple of things tonight. For January, our meetings are scheduled to be the 2nd of January, the 16th of January. January 2nd is the city's observed holiday for New Year. January 16th is Martin Luther King Day. So staff is proposing, would we be able to have a meeting, one meeting in January on the 9th of January?
I'll start with consensus from my left, Councilmember Bousquet.
It's my birthday. Do we really have to do that?
Birthday,
yeah, no.
That's
fine. I shouldn't have said anything.
Did you see what happened to City Manager McHugh?
Yeah, I'm gonna, I just realized that I'm going to suffer the consequences.
You sure? You still want to have the meeting January 9th?
Oh, no. Do I have a choice?
Well, we can get consensus. Is there another possible date,
City
Manager McHugh? Any other dates that we...
That was the date that we looked at. I mean, we could look at other dates, but that was really the only date that we looked at that was kind of in the middle of the month. If the council would like to look at other dates, we can look at other dates.
I'm fine with the 9th. I think we just have to see what happens.
I'll be out of town.
Well, it seems like attendance is optional nowadays anyways. Councilmember Diaz. Councilmember Dugo.
Yes.
I'll be available.
I am available.
All right, we'll celebrate your birthday together.
29th birthday, I believe.
All right, wonderful. The only other thing I had was just, and I'm sure everyone's aware, but I just wanted one last time to wish our Captain Moore well as he attends the FBI Academy, leaving in January. We'll be gone for 3 months. I know we'll be in good hands with Lieutenant Foreman, but we do wish you well, and we hope it's a wonderful experience for you. So, and with that, you know, Merry Christmas, Happy New Year, Happy Holidays to everyone.
Thank you. And our City Attorney's report?
No report tonight, but happy holidays as well to everybody.
Thank you. The Mayor's and City Council's report, start to my right, Council Deputy Mayor Tharp.
I was honored to join some staff members, Fire Rescue, over to Estero on the West Coast on the 8th to deliver some toys. We filled one of our trailers. Who was our driver? Was it
Ken Gibson?
Ken was our driver. Did amazing. We won't talk about Chief Fuller's driving, but that's okay. So, you know, extra thank you again to staff. PBSO, I know they stepped up with the donation. Fire Rescue, Austin back there, Suzanne Skidmore, all did an amazing job. So thank you from the bottom of my heart, and happy holidays to everyone.
Councilmember Dugo.
I would just like maybe to consider, get a consensus, even if not now or at the next meeting. Do we still want the acrylic dividers up? I'm wondering if it's maybe time for us. If you're comfortable enough, I would like them removed. Just feel like it's probably okay.
I mean, at this point, Councilmember Noble does wear a mask, right?
Sometimes.
Yeah.
Well.
Okay. Right. I mean, I think let's put her on the discussion item for the next meeting. I think that's the right thing to do. Anything else, Councilmember Dugo?
No, thank you.
Councilmember Diaz.
I just want to thank Ms. Thompson and all of the department directors that were a part of Elsie Swain's Mock City Council meeting last week. It was a lot of fun, and we all learned a lot. And really, other than that, just happy Hanukkah, a Merry Christmas, happy holidays, and happy New Year to everyone.
Thank you. Councilmember Biscay?
I will say, I know you put it on a discussion item for next meeting, but I'm adamantly against taking these down because there's a resurgence of everything right now. The hospitals are full. I don't feel safe without them. And I just, besides that, I'd like to wish everybody a happy holiday, Merry Christmas, Happy New Year, Happy Hanukkah.
Excellent. And for the mayor's report, I got three items. Piggybacking on what Councilmember Diaz said, kudos to our staff on the Mock City Council here in our chambers. Michelle, you and your team did a wonderful job, and City Manager McHugh, you and your staff having all the departments be part and actually present. It wasn't just a mock. It felt like it was an actual council meeting. So good job on that. I always enjoy that. We also had myself and Councilmember Diaz had the opportunity to go to Green Acres Elementary last week. And we had Governance Day in with them. We also had two school board members and a judge who talked to the kids. They came up with their own questions that we were able to answer. But it's great to be able to talk to them and show them what the importance of getting involved in local government and what it means. I know sometimes things get over them a little bit because they don't fully understand. I think we did a good job of, you know, talking about smaller issues that they see on their daily drive to school and things like that. So I thought that was really neat. And then the last item, I just want to let you know, I was reappointed to the executive board at the TPA. I think we've done a tremendous job there and continue to give Green Acres an outlet and a place that we can, you know, let our voice be heard. And the TPA is a great place to do so. We have some major thoroughfares that run through the city of Green Acres, so having a voice not only at the board but also at the executive board, I think it's always important. That concludes my report. And the meeting's adjourned.